I can't. It's too big.
Size matters not. Look at me. Judge me by my size, do you? And where you should not. For my ally is the Force. And a powerful ally it is. Life creates it. Makes it grow. Its energy surrounds us. And binds us. Luminous beings are we, not this crude matter. You must feel the Force around you. Here, between you, me, the tree, the rock, everywhere. Yes, even between the land and the ship.
Yoda, considered by some to be the avatar of the light, was a Force-sensitive male being of a mysterious and unknown species, and one of the most legendary, renowned, formidable, and powerful Jedi Masters in all of galactic history. He was known for his legendary and unparalleled wisdom, mastery of the Force, and devotion and skill in lightsaber combat. Yoda served as a member of the Jedi High Council in the waning centuries of the Galactic Republic, and as the Grand Master, oversaw the Jedi Order before, during and after the devastating Clone Wars conflict. Following the First Battle of Geonosis, Yoda also held the title of Master of the Order, after the title was forfeited by Mace Windu due to Mace wanting to take a more active role as a general in the Clone Wars, with Yoda possessing the two most prestigious and influential roles in all of the Jedi Order. Born in 896 BBY, just over a century after the Rusan Reformation, and subsequent annihilation of the Brotherhood of Darkness, Master Yoda was born with an exceptionally high midichlorian count of roughly 18,000 midichlorians to an unknown species on an unknown planet, the likes of which he would never reveal even during his long centuries as a Jedi Master. After departing this unknown world with a human friend, his ship crashed into a currently unknown swamp world where he was apprenticed to the Hislarian Jedi Master Nakata Del Gormo. After his rudimentary training with Gormo, he departed to Coruscant and was indoctrinated into the Jedi Order, eventually ascending to the title of Master, and later Grand Master of the Order. For over 800 years, Yoda had a hand in the training and teaching of nearly every single student that was admitted into the temple, including such aspiring prodigies such as Ki-Adi Mundi, Oppo Ren Sissus, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and even the Chosen One Anakin Skywalker. During 86 BBY, Yoda picked the prodigal Jedi Knight Dooku to become his apprentice, and taught him both in lightsaber combat as well as the Force. Yoda continued to reign as the Jedi Grandmaster centuries prior to the outbreak of the Clone Wars, in which Dooku, who had become disillusioned with the Jedi Order after the Naboo crisis and death of his Padawan Qui-Gon Jinn, and had been seduced by the dark side by Darth Sidious, following the outbreak of the Clone Wars. Yoda primarily acted as a strategist and tactician, however, there were various engagements and campaigns that he engaged in directly, in which he turned the tides of battle on his head. During the Clone Wars, he was lured to the dark side world of the Dune and very nearly killed by his fallen pupil Dooku. However, he managed to escape. During the twilight of the Republic, Yoda left for Kashyyyk to aid the Wookiees in their defense of Separatist occupation, and it would be during this time that Anakin Skywalker would fall to the dark side and be rechristened as Darth Vader, followed shortly thereafter by the execution of Clone Contingency Command 66, We saw Yoda's prize Jedi Order decimated in mere minutes. Despite this, Yoda managed to avoid being killed by his clone, and alongside Obi-Wan Kenobi and Bail Organa, ventured to Coruscant in secret, where he and Kenobi infiltrated the Jedi Temple and took on the task of facing the two Dark Lords of the Sith. Facing Sidious in the Senate Arena, they proved to be evenly matched, and thus Yoda fled into exile in the swamp world of Dagobah, where he would remain nigh undisturbed and nigh uncontacted for the greater part of two decades, with his only few interactions being with an Imperial historian who encountered him on Dagobah, and with the clone of Galen Merrick. In 3ABY, Luke Skywalker, the son of Anakin, came to Dagobah at the behest of the Force apparition Obi-Wan Kenobi to learn the ways of the Force from Yoda and complete his training. In the last years of his life, Yoda and Luke had numerous training sessions at various points throughout his life. Eventually, on his deathbed, Yoda proclaimed Luke a Jedi and transcended the ethereal plane to become a Force spirit, where his influence and teachings would shape the creation of Luke Skywalker's Jedi Praxium for many years to come. Considered by many, even his own colleagues, to be the greatest and most powerful Jedi Master of the era, and perhaps of all times up to that point, Yoda was one of the most skilled lightsaber duelers and users of the Force in the history of the galaxy. Yoda's immense powers in the Force and combat awestruck even the hot dark Jedi Veldorian, who grouped him among three elite Jedi Masters, along with Thon and Nomi Sunrider, who lived several millennia prior to Yoda. Veldorian considered the trio to be truly great as they were both prodigiously talented in the Force, specifically in the direction of pure light side energies and attacks. Of all the Force users in the galaxy, only Darth Sidious, perhaps the most powerful Sith Lord of all time, after the execution of Order 66 and thus gorging himself on the growing influence of the dark side, rivaled Yoda's mastery of the Force and his strength with lightsaber. In addition to his immense connection to the Force, Yoda was amazingly skilled in lightsaber combat, among the greatest duelers in history, and arguably the greatest Jedi duelist of all time, and was widely acknowledged as perhaps being the greatest Jedi duelist and sword master of his time, despite being trained initially as a Jedi Consular, who typically refrained from combat engagements and focused more on the study and intricacies of the Force. He was known to be the only Jedi who could ever base Mace Windu and Count Dooku on neutral ground, two swords when they were considered evenly matched. Although he did not often participate in direct combat one-on-one, Yoda's impeccable swordsmanship remained as sharp as ever. In his duel with Dooku on Geonosis, who had become Darth Tyrannus, despite having improved his skill even further and augmented his physical abilities with the dark side, Yoda held the upper hand throughout the majority of the fight and would have defeated him had Tyrannus not fled. This being the reason why Dooku fled, seeing that Yoda was far more skilled even after augmentation with the dark side. Testament to his unnatural experience in dueling was that Dooku, under his tutelage, became a swordsman of rare skill and elegance, quickly rising and ascending to surpass most Jedi apart from Windu and Yoda himself, with Dooku being able to defeat a Jedi Master in blade-to-blade combat by the time he was 14, defeating a Jedi Master perfectly and on neutral footing, being able to use this due to his mastery of Form 2 Makashi, which he had taught himself. Nearly inconceivable, however, was the last fight the small Jedi had against the leader of the CIS, which resulted in Dooku actually landing a hit, albeit a minor one, on the Master of Ataru, a feat thought basically impossible to accomplish due to Yoda's confounding speed, agility, and capacity with a lightsaber. Yoda was among the fastest duelers of all time in combat, and among the greatest abilities and users of the Force in history, being able to confound his enemies, even confounding Darth Sidious with his speed and skill. I do have to note one thing, however, that Dooku was only able to land a hit on Yoda while Yoda was conflicted about harming his former Padawan, and Dooku was taunting him and amplified by the power of a dark side necklace on Vajun. Another testament to Yoda's immense dueling skill, that he was not only able to fight on equal footing with Darth Sidious, but he was also even able to defeat and disarm the Dark Lord successfully, a feat that only Luke Skywalker, while empowered by the might and meditation of his family in unity with the Force, while Sidious's clone body was destabilizing, and Mace Windu, who was amplified by Sidious's own dark side power and Anakin Skywalker's Shatterpoint, were ever able to replicate. In fact, Sidious was so confused and confounded by Yoda's speed and skill, he considered Dooku to be a greater duelist than himself for a time after having learned that Dooku had matched him on Geonosis. Overall, Yoda's mastery of lightsaber combat marked him as among the greatest duelists of his time, with Sidious himself after having dueled Yoda, stating his belief that the Grandmaster would have, quote, destroyed Darth Vader if the young Sith had faced him rather than Kenobi on the lava banks of Mustafar. Yoda received intensive and extensive training in the usage and application of all seven forms of traditional lightsaber combat conceived by the time of the Clone Wars, and he had achieved full mastery and knowledge of them all and all of their stances and techniques, mastering them to perfection. Known to be the greatest lightsaber instructor in the temple and having a hand in training every single student admitted into the temple in lightsaber combat, his complete mastery of each form was such he was able to decide which one fitted his student the most and instruct them on how to use their specialized form effectively and effortlessly. His most preferred style in his life was Form 4 Ataru, which he particularly specialized at, as allowed him to compensate for his limited reach and small size as well as stature by putting in limited but very powerful acrobatic motions and strong strikes due to his blinding speed. Known to be the Order's greatest master of Ataru, even among the venerated Qui-Gon Jinn, his technique was also said to consist of the pure basics of Ataru taken to their highest possible level, brought to a level that was conceded to be impossible and nearly impossible to duel against. Despite his advanced age at the age of 800 and short stature, Yoda remained an exceptionally formidable duelist throughout his life, displaying an impressive speed and dexterity, leaping through the air and twirling as he batters an opponent's defenses like a dancer, dancing and completely around them, so that way they would become tired, fatigued, leaving openings for fatal counterattacks. Much of his lightsaber combat relied on various jumps and acrobatics, augmented by his mastery of Force Valor. Despite the fact that Yoda's primary combat specialization was Ataru, his skill in the form was such he was capable of effectively overcoming its weaknesses and shortcomings with ease, and demonstrated an extreme, nigh unprecedented level of skill with regard to deflecting blaster bolts, and could easily handle many opponents at once, evidenced by his easy victory over the various clone troopers when he returned to the Jedi Temple during Order 66. In addition, Yoda at times applied his mastery of other forms into his dueling style, and was known for having proficiently applied elements of Shicho Bladework, Form 1, with its outstanding deflection ability, implied a superb skill in either Shien or Sarisu, which he both also had mastery over. However, in his later years, particularly during his exile following the execution of Order 66 and his duel with Darth Sidious in the Senate Chamber, Yoda lost a great deal of his ability to move and mobility, demonstrating a pronounced limp and depending on a cane to aid him in his everyday movements. This loss of mobility was due to the fact that, in his old age of nearly 900, Yoda suffered from debilitating arthritis. When possible, Yoda preferred to use a hover chair rather than walk at all, something that was evident in the prequel trilogy as well. His mastery of Force Valor allowed him to overcome these physical infirmities for a short time, but due to the extremely taxing nature of the ability, he was only able to utilize it for a short time before tiring. Even a master such as Yoda of the Force could not use his ability for so long, however he could hold it for multiple minutes and perhaps even multiple tens of minutes. Even when he trained Luke Skywalker, however, Yoda still retained enough skill to effortlessly defeat his pupil with only a stick, in spite of Skywalker being armed with a blue-bladed lightsaber and employing a guided saber throw against him, and only lost when he allowed Skywalker to seize his stick. Master Yoda also was able to carry a green-bladed Shoto lightsaber, which, unlike most other lightsabers, possessed an ignition button that also acted as a clip. Yoda was one of the few Force users, Jedi and Sith alike, who clipped his trademark homespun robe on during conflict, probably because it was small enough not to hinder his movements. Yoda was similarly able to display his mastery of blaster fire when he fought his way to safety through a squad of clones during Order 66, and caged his way through a host of Saplunka probe droids, often moving faster than they could react or fire against him, with them being able to react at light speed beyond the capacity of a normal human easily. As noted in the novel Labyrinth of Evil, Master Yoda was a brilliant lightsaber duelist and not unacquainted with the power of the dark side, with an unparalleled ability to draw on the Force, granting him exceptional speed, agility, mobility, making his lightsaber abilities exceptionally potent. The Order's greatest master of Form 4 Ataru, and regarded as the latest lightsaber duelist in the Order, possessed of legendary skill with the blade. And the Jedi Archive even held a collection of data books to showcase his mastery and prowess for Jedi to study and aspire to. Having possessed knowledge and mastery of all seven lightsaber forms, his strength in the Force and fighting tactics allow him to overcome virtually any opponent, except when they are amped. Master Yoda is counted among the greatest Jedi warriors of his time and perhaps of all time, and Dooku believes that the Jedi Killer General Grievous to be far inferior to Master Yoda in lightsaber combat, even noting that stars would help him if he ever fought Yoda. Master Yoda's lightsaber skills are second to none on the Jedi High Council, surpassing even the legendary Master Mace Windu's skills, who successfully defeated Palpatine in formal combat. Master Yoda's lightsaber skills are also considered to be unparalleled, and reputed to be the greatest lightsaber master up to his time, although I have a personally different opinion. Darth Sidious also believes that Master Yoda would have absolutely destroyed Vader on Mustafar far worse than what Obi-Wan Kenobi would have done with him. And Master Yoda constantly bested Mace Windu in sparring matches, with his lightsaber skills making him a match for anyone in terms of formal combat. Master Yoda was also able to simply and without even moving cut down 10 battle droids, doing it effortlessly in a blinding flash of speed. And he was also seemingly able to employ saber throws alongside Obi-Wan Kenobi to cut down several clone troopers guarding and masquerading as Jedi near the Jedi Temple. Similarly, he's able to kill 8 soldiers in 6 seconds, and cut down 3 Separatist Occupatura droids effortlessly. Master Yoda is also believed to have defeated a dreaded Tyrantatech, a so-called Jedi killer on Kashyyyk, with the Tyrantatech being vicious, force-resistant Sith-spawned creatures requiring teams of Jedi to defeat in the Old Republic. Master Yoda was also able to, albeit with a little bit of effort, defeat a Bokashi Dark Jedi leader in an epic force clash, with the Dark Jedi being so powerful that his death created the dark side nexus potent enough to conceal Yoda's light side presence from the senses of Emperor Palpatine and Darth Vader alike during the era of the Empire. Yoda was also able to defeat a battalion of Separatist battle droids single-handedly, convincing King Katuko that a single Jedi is worth 1,000 battle droids. Yoda was a legendary Jedi Master and was able to engage the former Jedi Swordsmaster Count Dooku in combat, easily repelling all of his telekinetic and force lightning attacks, and engaging and defeating him in lightsaber combat, and then forcing him to flee the battle. As noted in Star Wars The New Essential Chronology, the duel with Dooku in Attack of the Clones, and Attack of the Clones Junior novelization alike. Master Yoda was an exceptionally formidable being in lightsaber combat, with Yoda having trained Dooku, and despite this, Dooku having grown in skill, he was able to still defeat him. Yoda was among the greatest warriors of his time without a shadow of a doubt. Was able to engage and defeat Count Dooku on the dark side nexus of the duel, forcing him to flee despite Count Dooku being amplified and Yoda being weakened by the natural dark side potency on the world. The quote from the book Yoda Dark Rendezvous goes as follows. With a bound, Yoda was at the casement, where he was windmilling down through the black air, screaming and tumbling towards the flagstones. Narrowing his eyes, Yoda reached out through the force and caught here north 3 meters from the ground. Instantly, he was in the air himself, spinning away from Dooku's vicious attack before he was even consciously aware it was coming. The blinding scarlet blur of Dooku's lightsaber split the air, slashing a burning line across Yoda's side before chopping the desk in half. Yoda whipped out his blade while trying to set Wuri gently down the cobblestones below. Wish to hurt you, I do not. That's odd, Dooku remarked. I intend to enjoy killing you. As Yoda released Wuri from his mind's hole and let it spill gently onto the flagstones far below, the tip of Dooku's lightsaber scored a burning line across his shoulder. The Count's blade was as quick as a viper striking. Among the other Jedi, perhaps only Mace Windu would have been his equal on neutral ground, but here on Vajun, steeped in the dark side, his blade worker's mallet made wickened calculus is cut in red light. I've hurt you, Dooku cried. Many times, Yoda said. He considered his pain. Let it drop. Now he had nothing but Dooku to focus on, and his lightsaber gleamed with the same fierce green light that flickered under his heavy-lidded eyes. But killed me you did not, when you had the chance. A mistake that was. More than 800 years Yoda has survived, through dangers you could not dream. I know how to kill, Dooku hissed. Yoda's eyes opened wide, like balls of green fire. Yes, but Yoda knows how to live. Then their blades clashed together in a lace of fire, green and red, but green burned hotter. Slowly, slowly, Dooku gave way. And in the dark, drunken Vajun air, Yoda was terrible to behold. Yes, Dooku whispered. Feel me. Feel the treason. All those years of teaching me, raising me, trusting me. And here I am, the favored son, butchering your precious Jedi one by one. Hate me, Yoda. You know you want to. Count Dooku lashed out with his lightsaber. Yoda took a quick step back and felt the heat of the red blade as it sliced the air centimeters from his tunic. He jumped, spun, and struck at Dooku's back before he landed. Dooku turned aside at the last moment, whipping his blade across the space where Yoda was seconds earlier. Facing each other again, their blades met, clashed, froze. Cunning you, I've had excellent teachers, Dooku said. Yoda dropped and rolled to the side, his lightsaber blazing, reaching for Dooku's ankle. Dooku leapt up and flipped backwards, landing lightly to face Yoda squarely. On his feet again, Yoda whirled and struck at Dooku, his green blade meeting Dooku's and pushing him back. Dooku attacked with reckless abandon, fueled with hatred. Their blades hummed together, hissing and sparkling. Dooku brought his blade down towards the diminutive Jedi Master and Yoda parried, locking his blade against Dooku's. Yoda breathed, calming himself. And yet, even here on Vajun, where the dark side whispers to me, love you enough to destroy you, I do. Pushing Dooku back again, the blades flash and flared stutters of light, blood red and sea green. Sweat rain and streams through Dooku's beard as he countered Yoda's every move, and his lips were white. Hollow battles raised around him as the console showed Obi-Wan and Anakin clashing with wave after wave of battle droids. Dooku shot a quick glance at the red button on his desk, and with a forced push, he punched it. Yoda cocked his head. A choice made, have you count? I am no longer your apprentice. Suit Dooku said between breaths. There was always a chance you could overpower me, of course. Yoda attacked, Dooku parried. So I put a missile in high orbit, slaved it to this location. It's falling now, gathering speed. Dooku stepped warily back to the open window casement. Can you feel it dropping? A thorn, a needle, an arrow, faster all the time. He paused to get his breath. Obi-Wan and your precious Skywalker and your little Padawans will be wiped out when the missile hits. So what do you need to decide is what means more to you, Master Yoda? Saving their lives or taking mine? And with that, he leapt backwards, out of the window. Yoda bounded after him. In the dark Vajun era, was all he could do to not leap after Dooku, to not fall on him like a green thunderbolt and annihilate him completely. But already he could feel the missile too, dropping in red screen through the atmosphere, 200 armor kilos of explosives. Aim for the Jedi. In perhaps the greatest display of his unparalleled mastery of form for Ataru and the lightsaber in general, as one of the greatest Jedi duelists and Force users of all time, Yoda was able to successfully engage Darth Sidious, the most powerful Sith Lord in all of history, in single combat. Though the Dark Lord was able to stalemate Yoda, Yoda proved an exceptionally formidable opponent, matching him and even disarming him in lightsaber combat and with the Force. With Sidious battling with passion and fury, only to be matched every blow by Yoda's calm and measured skill. With the Star Wars trading card game, noting that his true criminal colors revealed after Order 66 wiped out the Jedi Order on a galactic scale. Chancellor Palpatine accepts the title of Darth Sidious and all that goes with it. Reveling in his power, he is challenged by a feisty Yoda in the empty Coruscant Senate Chamber. It's a furious, unprecedented battle royale, with both adversaries hurling and dodging chamber pots. Ultimately, an overmatched Yoda flees to fight another day. I personally disagree with this statement. There are multiple contradictions, and Yoda is definitely not overmatched. His light was definitely contradicting and powerfully and defeating Palpatine's darkness. As similarly as such, I noted in the Revenge of the Sith Junior novelization, where the duel in the Senate Chamber is described as follows. As the hologram faded, Yoda stumbled into the room before the guards could react. He used the Force to fling them against the walls. They collapsed in motionless heaps as Yoda said to the Sith Lord, a new apprentice you have, Chancellor, or should I call you Emperor? Master Yoda, the Emperor inclined his head, you survived. Surprised? Your arrogance blinds you, Master Yoda. Darth Sidious hissed. Now you will experience the full power of the dark side. He raised his arms, and the Force pulsed as blue lightning blasted Yoda across the room. Master made a look from Chancellor to Yoda. His eyes narrowed maliciously. He turned and left the room. Another wave of dark power lifted Yoda and flung him hard against the wall. Yoda used the Force to cushion the impact but pretended to be knocked unconscious. A surprise I will give him. I have waited long enough in time for this moment, my little green friend. Darth Sidious sneered. He stepped forward and Yoda pushed off, propelling himself straight at the Sith Lord. He knocked Darth Sidious over the desk and stared down at him. At an end your rule is, Yoda told the Emperor, and not sure enough it was, I must say. He ignited his lightsaber and brought it down to be met by the Emperor's blood-red Sith blade. Strong this Sith Lord is, Yoda thought as their lightsabers whirled and clashed in world again. This is depicted in the Revenge of the Sith novelization, and similarly, in the Revenge of the Sith novel that was written by Matthew Stover, one of the best Star Wars novels of all time for me. The duel goes as follows. So easily slain, Obi-Wan is not. Neither are you, apparently. But that is about to change. The shadow took another step, and another. A lightsaber appeared, green as sunlight in a forest. The test of that today will be. Even a fraction of the dark side is more power than your Jedi arrogance can conceive. Living in light, you have never seen the depth of darkness. The shadow spread his arms and made its sleeve into black wings. Until now. Lightning spears from outstretched hands, and the battle was on. In the Senate arena, lightning fought from the hands of the Sith, and bent away from the gesture of a Jedi to shock Red Robes into unconsciousness. Then there were only two of them. Their clash transcended the personal. When new lightning blazed, it was not Palpatine burning Yoda with his hate. It was the Lord of all Sith scorching the Master of all Jedi into a smoldering huddle of clothing and green flesh. 1,000 years of Sith exalted in their victory. Your time is over. The Sith rule the galaxy, now and forever. And it was the whole of the Jedi Order that rocketed from its huddle, making of its own body a weapon to blast the Sith to the ground. I said, end your rulers, and not short enough it was, I must say. There appeared a blade of colour in the life, from the shadow of a black wing, a small weapon, a holdout, an easily concealed backup, a tiny bit of treachery expressing the core of Sith mastery, slid into a withered hand and spat a flame-coloured blade of its own. When those blades met, it was more than just Yoda and Palpatine, more than the millennia of Sith against legions of Jedi. This was the expression of the fundamental conflict of the universe itself. Light against dark, winner take all. Became a turning point in the clash of light against dark. It did not come from a flash of lightning or a slash of energy blade, though there were these in plenty. It did not come from a flying kick or a surgically precise punch, though these were traded too. It came as the battle shifted from the holding office to the great Chancellor's podium. It came as a hydraulic lift beneath the podium razor on a tower of durasteel 100 meters and more, so that it became a laser point of blaring, flaring focus, the battle flaring at focus of vast emptiness of the Senate arena. It came as the force in the podium's controls ripped delegation pods free of curving walls and made them more of hammers, battering rams, catapult stones, crashing and crushing against each other in a rolling thunder roar that echoed the Senate's cheers for the galaxy's new emperor. It came when the Avatar of the Light resolved into the lineage of the Jedi, and when the lineage of the Jedi refined into one single Jedi. It came when Yoda found himself alone against the dark. In that lightning-speared tornado of feet and fists and blades and bashing machines, his vision finally pierced the darkness that had clouded the Force. Finally, he saw the truth. This truth, that he, the Avatar of the Light, supreme master of the Jedi Order, the fiercest, most implacable, most devastatingly powerful foe the darkness had ever known, just didn't have it. He had never had it. He had lost before he started. He had lost before he had born. The Sith had changed. The Sith had grown, had adapted, had invested 1,000 years of intensive study into every aspect of not only the Force, but Jedi lore itself, in preparation for exactly this day. The Sith had remade themselves. They had become new. While the Jedi had spent that same millennium training to refight the last war. The new Sith could not be destroyed by a lightsaber. They could not be burned away by any torch of the Force. The brighter his light, the darker their shadow. How could one win a war against the dark, when the war itself had become the dark's own weapon? He knew at that instant that this inside held hope of the galaxy, but if he fell here, that hope would die with him. Yoda thought, the problem this is. The end came with astonishing suddenness. The shadow could feel how much it cost a little green freak to bend his lighting back into a cage of energy that enclosed them both. The creature had reached the limits of his strength. The shadow released its power for an instant, long enough to only whirl away through the air and alight upon one of the delegation pods as it flew past, and the creature left out to follow half a second too slow. The shadow unleashed its lightning while the creature was still in the air, and the little green freak took its full power. The shock blasted him backwards to crash against the podium, and he fell. He fell a long way. In my personal opinion, this is Yoda's greatest display of combat, as Palpatine is easily the most experienced and powerful lightsaber duels he ever faced. Above even the likes of Count Dooku, who he sparred with and dueled formerly on Vajun, and Mace Windu, who rivaled Dooku and would eventually defeat pre-Order 66 Palpatine prior to his amplification to his power. With regards to his Force powers, Yoda, as befitting a centuries-old Jedi Grand Master, was extraordinarily powerful and skilled in the Force, unprecedentedly and undoubtedly one of the most powerful Force users in history, rivaling Darth Sidious, his dark side counterpart. It was the greatest and strongest master of the Force among the Jedi of his time, surpassing the even potentially more powerful Anakin Skywalker due to having far more experience in using it. Luke Skywalker considered Yoda's powers as of Empire Strikes Back far past his prime to be far beyond what Darth Vader could be capable of, and likewise felt that Yoda was much more powerful than he was as of 9 ABY during the Thrawn campaign. His own power in the Force was described as being as light as a star, and his midichlorian count was known to be the second highest in the history of the Jedi, surpassed only by the Chosen One Anakin Skywalker. His strength and mastery of the Force was great enough so he could easily defend himself against and dominate other powerful adepts of the Force. As shown where he casually repelled all of Dooku's Force assaults, despite the increase in power and skill Dooku had acquired from turning to the dark side. Yoda was similarly able to use two dominants to such a masterful extent. He was able to block both blaster fire and force lightning from Dooku with ease, with the force lightning from Dooku being exceptionally powerful and Yoda having no experience using it against electrical discharges of such potency. Yoda was so powerful and prodigiously skilled in the force combat, he could also effortlessly overpower highly skilled and armed adversaries using nothing but the force, as evidenced with the Sarge Ventress in the Clone Wars. Indeed, Yoda was the only one to have ever managed to go single-handedly up against Darth Sidious in Force combat, and was able to match the Dark Lord to a draw, stalemating him, although he proved incapable of defeating him as they were evenly matched. His power and skill in the Force remained tremendous, even as he continued to age and lost its former great mobility. Even the Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Tyrannus and Darth Sidious, acknowledged his Force power and mastery, with Darth Tyrannus holding his former master's strength in the Force high enough to regard that he believed should Yoda ever accept the dark side, he would be so unfathomably powerful that not even Darth Sidious would be able to hold a candle to his immense power. Befitting his extraordinary willpower, Yoda was extremely skilled and masterful in the use of mind-related and telepathic-related powers. He could effortlessly cast mind tricks that were easily strong enough to effectively manipulate strong-willed individuals, such as Captain Kypho, and he could easily delve deep into the minds of others to decipher their thoughts with great precision and accuracy. Yoda's telepathic capabilities also allowed him to manipulate the memories of his targets. Thinking about doing so to an Imperial historian who discovered him on Dagobah, but ultimately deciding against it, believing that the Force would guide the historian to do what fate saw right. Yoda was also extraordinarily skilled in telekinesis. He demonstrated on one occasion the ability to easily lift and telekinetically carry an X-Wing, despite being far past his prime and rather fatigued. And during the Battle of Coruscant, he duplicated both Darth Nihilus's telekinetic feat and Tula Kord's telekinetic feat by causing a pair of C-9979 landing craft to collide with each other on two occasions, with this being arguably one of the greatest telekinetic feats in all of Star Wars. In their duel on Geonosis, Yoda easily deflected every telekinetic assault that Darth Tyrannus threw at him, who, surprisingly and conveniently, was the former temple instructor of telekinesis. Yoda was also able to catch Darth Sidious off guard with the Force, push that blasted Sidious far away from him, and later managed to stop a Senate hoverpod that Sidious hurled at him from above, and then proceeded to utilize the Force to rotate it and throw it back at him. An all the more impressive feat due to the fact that the pod was thrown upwards against gravity towards the enemy. He could even effortlessly toy with the very powerful Asajj Ventress, who could rival the likes of Savage Opress, who has shown on multiple occasions to surpass the likes of Plo Koon and Kit Fisto. With Ventress personally killing and defeating Fisto, it could hold her own against the very likes of Mace Windu and Anakin Skywalker, using only telekinesis, and he was even able to easily send her flying, stop her strike in midair, and then even go as far to casually disarm her of her lightsabers with a simple gesture. A master practitioner of the Force push and Force wave powers, Yoda used his abilities in conjunction with Mace Windu to blast away dozens, if not hundreds, of battle droids simultaneously during the Battle of Coruscant, and then single-handedly raise an expensive force of Separatist battle droids into the air, ensuring they would collide into the incoming airborne Separatist attack ships, being one of the primary defenses of Coruscant, while Mace Windu attempted to secure Chancellor Palpatine, which eliminated the two attack forces in one single stroke. Master Yoda in combat was also adept at the saber throw, as demonstrated in his return to the Jedi Temple during the Great Jedi Purge. Yoda was also able to display an astounding level of mastery with the usage of the defensive power of two dominants, using it effortlessly during his duel with Darth Tyrannus on Geonosis to effortlessly absorb and redirect the Sith Lord's Force Lightning with little to no effort. And, most impressively, he was able to redirect and absorb Darth Sidious's electrical discharge, eventually managing to coalesce the energy from the Dark Lord of the Sith's Force Lightning into a blue orb of pulsating dark side power between the two of them, which slowly redirected the lightning back onto an astounded and confounded Sidious, causing him to slowly reel backwards with the strength of Yoda's counterattack before the combination of both their Force powers blasted the two of them apart. Yoda was similarly able to utilize the Force Valor ability to improve his physical attributes with the Force, and even after his exile, was so powerful in the Force, he was able to resist old age long enough to train Luke, literally prolonging his life via his will. Yoda could, with great effort, use the Force to stifle and quash the efforts of his enemies to draw on the Force, mitigating their abilities and power to draw upon it. However, despite his great power and skill as a warrior, Yoda was known to strongly detest combat in general, and was even a bit disdainful that the idea of greatness and honor could be achieved through martial prowess and succession. Master Yoda was able to foresee events with great clarity, rivaling that of even Darth Sidious, Tenebrae, and Anakin Skywalker. In addition, Yoda had an exceptionally powerful Force sensors, as he was able to quickly sense the deaths of almost every single member of the Jedi Order and identify each one easily, while simultaneously sensing that Anakin Skywalker had turned to the dark side, even all the way from Kashyyyk across the galaxy. Yoda was able to sense the deaths of over 10,000 members of the Jedi Order at the same time, identifying and relating and sympathizing with each one. Due to his training with Qui-Gon Jinn in the ethereal plane, Yoda acquired the power to retain his identity after becoming one with the Force, and was even able to ponder matters of the light and dark side of the Force with unparalleled clarity that surpassed all other Jedi of his time, even Mace Windu. He was the most skilled user of Force empathy among the Jedi, exceeding even the renowned empathetic abilities of Deppa Balaba, who had been noted by Mace Windu as an exceptionally powerful practitioner of the ability. Innately, he could sense intense feelings coming from others, even from other planets across the galaxy. He was able to sense the immense pain Anakin felt from the death of his mother while the latter was on Tatooine, even though Yoda was on Coruscant and meditating. He also easily sensed the tension between Kenobi and Anakin when they pursued Dooku and was able to identify the cause as Padme's fall from the light gunship. Yoda was also quite proficient in the valued Force technique of battle meditation, having even been able to determine the outcomes of battles by lifting the morale of thousands of companions while simultaneously dampening the spirits of thousands of opponents. Yoda was able to enter a trance-like state, and when he emerged, his ability to use the Force was briefly more focused and refined. Moreover, he was able to summon and direct the power of Emerald Lightning, also known as Electric Judgment, such as when he falls against Darth Sidious. In addition, Yoda could utilize Force Harmony to defend himself from dark powers and even shatter powers already in effect. This ability became more effective if Yoda was able to join his power with that of any other Jedi. Yoda was believed by Luke to have, in 3ABY, used the Force to disable the sensors of the young Jedi's ship, and then used the Force to guide the craft where it needed to be. It was also capable of using it to inspire great amounts of hope while simultaneously eliminating feelings of doubt and despair from the spirit of others with a single touch. As he did to saturate Palius Chuff with feelings of hope and potential mission success, also completely dispersing his feelings about doubt, despair, and anger. Yoda was also extremely proficient in the usage of the Force to preserve light, having learned a myriad of powers that allowed himself to heal himself, others, and even keeping himself alive through sheer willpower until he trained Luke Skywalker. But just before he allowed himself to pass into the Force, he admitted he was at the end of his strength due to the great power required for such a feat being nigh unprecedented. And upon his death, Yoda's body vanquished and became a Force ghost. However, despite his advanced skill and power in the Force, he was only able to lift 5 of the 7 Munto stones while in meditation, once he passed his 700th year. Moreover, Yoda was aware of several Sith spells, though he did not use them, and understood the dark side powers to kill with a touch or take total control over a victim. Though again, he's not known to actually use these dark side powers. Yoda contemplated using the dark side to remove all memory of himself from a man, but ultimately decided that to do so would be wrong, and instead did what the Force felt was guiding him right, and spare the historian's life. With regards to his overall accolades in the Force, Master Yoda has been credited as the most famous, venerable Jedi Master in the entire Jedi Order. Renowned for his wisdom and mastery of the Force, Master Yoda was among the most powerful Force users of all time, reputed as the wisest of all the Jedi, and alongside Mace Windu, Master Yoda is the most senior and powerful and respected member in the entirety of the Jedi Order, with it being noted in many books such as Dark Disciple and the Star Wars Fact Finder. Master Yoda is the most skilled and experienced Jedi Master in the Order, and possesses the wisdom, inner strength, and unparalleled knowledge of the Force to overcome nearly any challenge the Jedi Order could face. With Master Yoda's knowledge of the Force making him just as powerful as Darth Sidious, this places him above the likes of Count Dooku, who constantly dominates Dooku throughout the Clone Wars, with Sidious constantly dominating Dooku. This also places him above the power level of Mace Windu, as he is able to fight post-Order 66 Palpatine as an equal, with this Palpatine being amplified in power, after gorging himself on the growing influence of the dark side across the galaxy. Master Yoda is also considered to be an extraordinarily powerful Jedi Master, and among the most powerful of all time, with the Hasbro Yoda action figure noting that the oldest member of the Jedi High Council, Yoda is a wise and cautious master. When Obi-Wan informs the Council of the Separatist plans, Yoda assembles the clone army to subdue the rebellion. Yoda's unassuming size masks his enormous powers. His skills in the Force are not limited to wisdom and guidance, but are matched by his dexterity and fighting prowess. With the Star Wars Mystery of the Jedi book, also noting that Yoda is an exceptionally powerful Jedi and can control blue crackling Force lightning. Master Yoda also possessed the innate, incomparable ability to summon the power of the Force, despite his frailty, with Senator Bail Organa, considering Obi-Wan Kenobi and Master Yoda, be two of the greatest and most powerful Jedi in the galaxy, the Revenge of the Sith Jr. novelization going as follows. Bail parted from Obi-Wan and Yoda at the Senate landing platform. The two Jedi used their mind-clouding abilities to pass the Red Guards, then raised their hoods and slipped off. Bail watched them go with considerable misgiving. They were undoubtedly two of the best and most powerful Jedi in the galaxy, and they were warned and ready. There were thousands of clone troopers and security guards. If they were discovered and it came to battle. Also, a young Jedi Anakin Skywalker considered Yoda to be potentially the greatest master, with him being the presence of the great, perhaps the greatest Jedi master, was as deep and huge as Anakin's rage. With Darth Sidious, in his guise as Emperor Palpatine, considering Master Yoda to be the greatest of all Jedi. With Grandmaster Luke Skywalker, considering Master Yoda to be one of the wisest and most powerful Jedi ever in the New Jedi Order Force Heretic 3 reunion. Luce faced the image now, smiling. On the first night we came here, Jabita said something similar to my nephew. The Magister looked up at his words but didn't interrupt. She became indignant that Jason should dare speak for the living Force. The implication that someone so small in the great cosmos shouldn't dare presume to speak for such a powerful thing. But the fact is, the living Force can choose anyone it wants. Size is not important. Master Yoda was smaller than anyone here, yet he was the wisest person I ever met, as well as one of the most powerful Jedi Masters to ever live. You possess a power, Sakot, that is beyond the imagining of virtually all sentient beings. That doesn't automatically mean your connection to the Force is greater. Mace Windu was also noted in Yoda Dark Rendezvous to be admitting directly to Palpatine that Master Yoda was his superior as a warrior. Duty calls, Palpatine said, moving to cut the comm channel. Then he paused. Master Windu, since we are being frank with one another today, let me add that in these briefings, I wish to hear your own unvarnished opinions. Not what you think of Master Yoda would have said, but he is great, perhaps the greatest Jedi in the Republic. But Master Yoda is a teacher at heart. You are a warrior. Regrettably, this is a sad age of the world, may be more your time than his. Master Yoda is many things, and I am not his equal in peace or in war. Dooku also considers Yoda in the Legacy of the Jedi book to be the greatest Jedi Master who had ever lived, and he's consistently stated to be one of, if not the most powerful Jedi in all of galactic history, in my opinion, surpassing the likes of the Outlander from the Old Republic era, who was able to defeat and conquer Emperor Vitiate, although Vitiate was holding back and underestimating the Outlander, with Master Yoda being considered to be the living embodiment of the will of the Force. At almost 900 years old, Master Yoda was the longest living Jedi and Grand Master of the Jedi Order in the days before the Empire. He trained thousands of Jedi students in the temple's classes and saw hundreds become Jedi Masters. Everyone in the Jedi High Council was at one time his student, and they all considered him the living embodiment of the will of the Force. Perhaps only Master Mace Windu equaled him in skill and reputation, though Master Windu argued that he was still but a Padawan compared to Master Yoda. And Master Yoda was even noted to be perhaps the greatest Force Master of all time. By the Star Wars Absolutely Everything You Need to Know book, noted as perhaps the most famous teacher and master of the Order. With regards to his farsight abilities, Farsight is the Jedi power to peer into the future or the past and receive visions from the Force. Jedi can often perceive future events, but such visions are often unreliable and, as always in motion, is the future. With Master Yoda being specifically renowned for his precognitive abilities and powers, in addition to his age, Master Yoda's powers of Farsight were one reason for Yoda possessing the ultimate position of authority on the Jedi Council, being far above everyone else on the Council in terms of power, even Mace Windu, Ki-Adi Mundi, and Obi-Wan Kenobi, with perhaps his only equal being the young Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker. Master Yoda, alongside Darth Sidious, was one of the greatest practitioners of Farsight during the era of the Old Republic, with the Jedi vs. Sith the essential guide to the Force noting as much. Master Yoda's wisdom in the realm of Farsight and visions granted by the Force was such he was able to record his teachings in the one artifact the Jedi valued more than their temple, the Great Holocron, with the Master Yoda section in the Jedi vs. Sith The Essential Guide to the Force noting as follows. Often difficult to see the future is, like searching for raindrops beneath the surface of water, but raindrops do fall, and discern the depths they can be. Fleeting can be visions of the future, momentary glimpses of both the familiar and the strange. More dangerously are clear visions, as easy as it is to confuse clarity with the truth. Truth can be murky, and crucial is perspective to any vision. See you do from the right angle at the wrong time, or from the wrong angle at the right time. No perspective is fixed. Frequently am I asked if inevitable is the future. The visions reveal what may be or what will be. Knowing you will when a vision is what will be. Feel it by the force you will. Know you will whether to chase raindrops before they fall or remain where they are. Stay where you are, and move you will anyway. Always in motion, the future is. Master Yoda's powers of Farsa were even known to be exceptional during the time of the New Jedi Order and the Yuuzhan Vong, with the New Jedi Order Dark Side Onslaught noting as much. With them noting, his uncle Master Yoda was known for his wisdom and ability to see pieces of the future. Jason had never really felt he'd been gifted by a vision of the Force, but it didn't seem to him as if it was just the sort of thing a vision like that would entail. Similarly, long after his death, the fate of the Jedi Apocalypse knocked. Luke Skywalker notes that Master Yoda told him once of the Ones of Mortis because he sensed that Luke would one day need that information, peering into the future. Yoda also senses that Obi-Wan Kenobi would become apprentice to a Jedi Master, with the quote in Jedi Apprentice The Rising Force noting as follows. Obi-Wan felt his hopes dim. Qui-Gon had rejected so many students. What made him think he would be able to please him? He won't want me, Obi-Wan said in defeat. He's seen me fight, and he did not choose me then. No one will. Yoda squinted at Obi-Wan with wise eyes. Always in motion, the future is. One cannot be sure, but I have sensed a kind of destiny for you. Something in Yoda's tone made Obi-Wan wonder. Will he choose me? He asked. On Qui-Gon that depends, and you, Yoda said. Come back tomorrow and fight for him with the Force as your ally. Perhaps accept you, he will. Yoda put a comforting hand on his arm. Either way, it matters not. Leave the temple soon, you shall. But I tell you must. To lose such an apt pupil, I am sorry. Yoda was also able to foresee that Obi-Wan would fight before Qui-Gon Jinn, with Master Yoda sharing a vision with Luke Skywalker in the Empire Strikes Back official novelization, with the quote going as follows. Be calm, Yoda told him. Through the Force, things you will see, other places, other thoughts, the future, the past, old friends long gone. Luke was losing himself as he concentrated on Yoda's word. He was becoming unaware of his body, and let his consciousness drift with the words of his master. My mind fills with so many images. Control, control, you must learn of what you see, the Jedi Master instructed. Not easy, not fast. Luke closed his eyes, relaxed, and began to free his mind, began to control the images. At last, there was something, not clear at first, but something white, amorphous. Gradually, the image cleared, and it seemed to be that of a city that perhaps floated in a billowing white sea. I see a city in the clouds, he finally said. Bespin, Yoda identified it. I see it too. Friend you have there, here? Concentrate, and see them you will. Luke's concentration intensified, and the city in the clouds became clearer. As he concentrated, he was able to see forms, familiar forms of people he knew. I see them, Luke exclaimed, his eyes still shut. Then a sudden agony of body and spirit took hold of him. They're in pain. They're in suffering. It is the future, you see, the voice of Yoda explained. Master Yoda was also able to put his ability of Farsight in reverse and peer into the past after editing meditation. Master Yoda was also able to sense that Luke Skywalker and Leia Organa would have part to play in the time after the Great Jedi Purge and the reconstitution and rebuildment of the Jedi Order. Master Yoda was also able to search through the fog of the dark side to peer into the future and receive a brief but vague glimpses of something far worse than war, as explored in the Attack of the Clones Junior novelization. Palpatine stared at them for a moment, then turned. Master Yoda, do you think it will really come to war? Yoda closed his eyes and folded his long, flexible ears down, the better to feel the future shifting of the Force. The dark side hung like a thick fog over everything, hiding even the near events that usually were so clear, and growing more dense the further ahead he tried to look. Lightsabers flashed blue and green in the fog, but few, too few, and he caught more and more glimpses of a glowing red that no Jedi would ever wield. Worse than war, I fear, he murmured. Much worse. Similarly, Yoda was a master of Force concealment. Force concealment and abilities such as Force Stealth govern the ability for a Force user to render themselves undetectable by non-Force sensitives and Force-sensitive individuals alike. And being one of the most notable users of this ability was Darth Malgus, Palpatine, and Plagueis. Master Yoda was able to conceal his Force presence from Luke Skywalker during Empire Strikes Back, along upon the young Jedi prodigy's arrival at Dagobah, and he was also able to conceal his presence in the Force from his own pupil Count Dooku, despite being on the potent dark side steep nexus of the Jun, which would have debilitated his ability to call and utilize the Force in such a way. And he was able to also utilize the Force to withdraw as much of his potent power as much from possible on Dagobah, especially when the Starkiller clone departed and went there. Similarly, Force healing was the ability that allowed a Jedi to heal the wounds of either self or others. With the ability, can allow a Jedi to heal wounds suffered from blunt force trauma, sharp force trauma, blaster bolt burns, lightsaber scores, broken bones, and force lightning. With Master Yoda successfully instructing Luke in the usage of such abilities, he was able to heal the Jedi Jor Kadas with the Force, and states that he can use the Force to ease the passing of others into the physical realm. He was also able and a complete master of the ability of Force Valor, with Force Valor being an umbrella term that refers to the ability to augment one's physical abilities to perform superhuman feats, with Force abilities under this umbrella including Force Jump, Force Speed, etc. With Master Yoda possessing unparalleled skilling, creating and increasing his physical abilities through the Force, possessing incredible and amazing strength and speed, and could run faster than the average human even near the age of 900. He was then able to use the Force to correctly sense, and then cut down several chameleon droids before they could fire upon him, and was able to cut down several more chameleon droids before they can even react. Master Yoda was also able to evade the tracking missiles and maneuvers of a Hailfire droid, displaying impressive evasive maneuvers that a clone trooper likened to the maneuvers a star pilot would perform. Even more impressive, as Hailfire droids had split-second reaction time and the blaster bolts were shot faster than light speed. Master Yoda was also able to keep himself alive and sustain himself via the Force until Luke Skywalker's Jedi training was complete, and only then did he allow old age and sickness to take him and allow him to pass into the cosmic Force and become a Force apparition. Master Yoda was also a complete master of the ability of Tutor Minus, and one of the greatest masters, especially considering Jedi, in galactic history with regards to the ability. Tutor Minus, for any clarification, is the Force ability that allows a Force user to contain, absorb, and deflect various bursts of harmful energy, radiation, and electrical discharge. Standard applications allow Force users to deflect harmful radiation such as sunlight, while more advanced applications can deflect and absorb blaster bolts and even Force lightning, with Yoda capable of controlling Force lightning. On Geonosis, when facing against Count Dooku, Yoda's easy parrying and indeed handling of the Sith lightning Dooku hurled at him has come as a surprise to the Dark Lord, easily being able to repel it back at him. He was then able to absorb and dissipate Count Dooku's lightning into his hand, absorbing power. Master Yoda was also able to correctly counter Darth Sidious's second barrage of Force lightning launched in the Senate chamber, and absorbed the incredibly potent Force lightning of Sidious, eventually forcing the two bolts of energy to form a coalescive stalemate that sends them both flying off a Senate plot. Master Yoda was also a prodigious acumen and adept in the ability of Force Sense governing a Force user's perceptive abilities. Through this power, Jedi are able to sense other individuals and Force users alike, the emotions of others, as well as centers of Force energy, being Nexa. Master Yoda is said to be able to sense disturbances in the Force from possible parsecs away, and was able to sense Luke Skywalker's impatience, and the destruction of Alderaan, and the death of Obi-Wan Kenobi, despite being on Dagobah with Kurt. Master Yoda was also able to sense surges in the Force, and sense a young Anakin Skywalker's tempered fear, and was able to sense Anakin Skywalker's fury and anger. He was also able to sense Qui-Gon Jinn's traits of defiance appearing in Obi-Wan Kenobi gradually in The Phantom Menace, and senses concern in Mace Windu because of him. Master Yoda senses the feelings of shock in his fellow higher council members during the attack of the Clones Jr. novelization, and was able to sense Padme Amidala's grief from across the galaxy. Master Yoda was also able to sense the fear of Republic senators, even at a distance while not being in the Senate itself, and was able to peer and search through Obi-Wan Kenobi's own thoughts, an impressive feat, as Obi-Wan Kenobi was one of the most powerful Force sensitives in galactic history, especially considering Jedi. He was also able to sense a bomb that had been secretly planted to kill him, and was able to sense that Obi-Wan Kenobi survived the ambush on Geonosis, and sensed that Obi-Wan, alike, and Anakin can still be alive on the team. Master Yoda was also able to sense Chancellor Palpatine's fear in the Attack of the Clones novelization. And the quote goes as follows. Palpatine nodded grimly, and Yoda sensed a strong fear from the man, as if he knew that he was about to be thrust forward in the most dangerous position he and the Republic had ever known. Master Yoda was similarly able to sense disturbances in the Force, signaling a separatist attack on Coruscant, being the Battle of Coruscant at the tail end of the Clone Wars, and was able to sense the immense fear and pain emanating from the planet of Lantine. Master Yoda was also able to sense the death of his fellow contemporary and the only female currently known member of his species, Master Yaddle's death on Mulan. Felt the Force move, I did. No idea that she was gone. Prepared my transformer for Mulan, I already have. Her work must carry on. May the Force be with us. Master Yoda was also adept in the usage of the dark side, although he mainly refrained from using such abilities. He was able to utilize the dark side to probe and push further into the future to pierce through the gaze of darkness that currently shrouded the galaxy. And he was able to sense the dark shroud of the Sith, sensing Anakin Skywalker's slaughter of the Tusken Raiders who captured his mother, and hearing the cries of Qui-Gon Jinn's disembodied voice after his death in Attack of the Clones. Master Yoda was also able to sense the fall of Anakin Skywalker as he was re-christened as Darth Vader and indoctrinated into the Sith, and the events that occurred shortly afterwards on the Showdown of Coruscant, including the precise deaths of Mace Windu, Saya Setin, Agen Kola, and Kit Fisto. With Master Yoda sensing the Jedi deaths across the galaxy and the betrayal of his clone soldiers, to the very detail, he could sense how they died, which Jedi had died. With thousands of Jedi dying per minute after the initiation of Clone Contingency Order 66, and Yoda could sense all of them. Yoda is arguably, in my personal opinion, having one of the most potent Force sensibilities in all of Star Wars, at least among the Jedi, perhaps being greater than even Luke Skywalker. Master Yoda was able to sense and cut down several chameleon droids, and was able to sense the emergence of the dark side 200 years prior to the emergence of the Sith Lord Darth Maul, revealed his existence to the Sith at the Battle of Naboo, and was aware of the gradual re-emergence of the dark side itself. Master Yoda was also able to stretch his senses across the galaxy to peer into the minds of other Jedi, allowing him to see what they see, as if they were remote sensors, and stretched his senses so far across Coruscant to witness the events of the battle across the planet and in the space above planet, and even perceive Darth Sidious. The quote goes as follows, from Labyrinth of Evil. Yoda paced away from the console, deliberately turning his back to the glut of devices, screens, data, displays, in a kind of countermeasure, shutting his eyes to distance himself farther. He stretched out with his feelings, placing his mind's eye, Mace and Kit Fisto skimming through the deranged sky, Shuck T and Star Sully hurrying towards Palpatine's quarters in 500 Republica, Saysay Tin, Agen Kola, Boltar Swan, and other Jedi Masters and Jedi Knights streaking from Coruscant's enveloping their starfighters. Local space flashing with energy bolts and globular explosions. Ships too numerous to count embroiled in a monumental battle. Grievous was losing his war machines against both military and civilian targets, firing at anything and everything that wandered into his sights, commanding his droid fighters to dash themselves against Coruscant's defensive umbrellas, or race down through traffic lanes, initiating chain reactions of collisions. And yet, for all the diversion, disruption, and terror with the stratagems incited, they had little to do with the real battle. As it was true with the war itself, the real battle was being fought with the Force. Yoda stretched out farther, immersing himself fully in the Force, only to feel his breath catch in his throat. Frigid the current became, arctic, and for the first time, he could feel Sidious, feel him on Coruscant. With regards to his more out-of-the-ordinary Force abilities, Yoda was proficient with the ability of Alter Environment, a Jedi's ability to manipulate and coerce the natural surroundings, such as water, air, etc., and use it to their advantage by freezing water or air or manipulating cold covering, as he was able to create a pocket of air to hold back the very vacuum of space in Yoda Dark Rendezvous. Similarly to many notable Jedi Masters of the Old Republic, such as Satele Shan or Nomi Sunrider, Yoda was an immense prodigy at battle meditation, the Jedi art of utilizing the Force to infuse allies with confidence and morale, while also diminishing the morale of enemies. Potent applications of this can even increase the combat skill of ally to turn the tide of any battle. He was a master of battle meditation, and potentially uses battle meditation to infuse Palius Chuff with courage, even using battle meditation with the Wookiees during the Battle of Kashyyyk. As befitting many other Jedi Masters, he was also a master of the Jedi Mind Trick ability, with him able to enter Obi-Wan's mind before. Even Master Yoda, where the touches had been gentle, almost a caress, with Obi-Wan noting that unlike Yoda's touches, Dooku's mental harm was painful and humiliating. The most basic and well-known of Force abilities, Yoda was an absolute master of telekinesis, using Force pull to disarm an assailant, using the Force to slow his fall, using the Force to lift himself and Palius Chuff over a starfighter, and using the Force to pull himself and Palius Chuff up onto the underside of a starfighter. I cannot stress enough how masterful Yoda was with telekinesis. He was able to easily lift a boulder the size of a family-sized electric cart with merely a gesture, and lift R2-D2 droid with telekinesis. Master Yoda was similarly able to lift heavy Durasteel containers, and easily repel objects thrown at him by Count Dooku on Geonosis, even casting aside pieces of torn ceiling effortlessly. However, his ability to control multiple objects telekinetically, for instance more than two or three objects, was limited for his age. Yoda was also able to use the Force to heft three battle droids aside easily, using telekinesis to take out an additional four, and nonchalantly utilized telekinesis to incapacitate a pair of Darth Sidious' Royal Guardsmen instantly. These Royal Guardsmen, also known as the Red Guards, were known to turn the tides of battle on their heads themselves. Master Yoda was also able to effortlessly destroy several assassin droids utilizing only the cosmic power of the Force, and pushed down dozens of guards simultaneously with just a pure telekinetic strike. Similarly, Yoda, during his confrontation with Darth Sidious, was able to halt a Senate pod thrown by Sidious, and then throw it back at the Sith Lord after rotating it. An even more impressive feat is it was at the opposite of the center of gravity, pushing up against the wind. Yoda was able to hold a collapsing steel pillar before it could pulverize Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker in Attack of the Clones. And in the Star Wars fact file saying, while Yoda used his mighty Force skills to hold the metal column in mid-air, and then sent it crashing away from them, Dooku made his getaway. However, his telekinesis was limited after he passed the age of 700. However, prior to this, Master Yoda was still able to effortlessly lift all of the six of the Jedi Munto stones before the age of 700, after which he could only lift five of them in concentrated meditation, with the Munto stones weighing each about 5 metric tons, with Yoda being regularly able to exercise his control over telekinesis by lifting 35 metric tons before the age of 700. Master Yoda in Yoda Dark Rendezvous was also able to suspend an animation, throwing food, drinks, and utensils in the air and gently settle them back down as if they hadn't been disturbed at all. Conveniently, and also in Yoda Dark Rendezvous, Master Yoda used the Force push to push a missile so that it misses its target by 1 kilometer. With a snort, Yoda turned his eyes to the sky and picked out the glowing dot racing in from the horizon. Below him, Dooku landed softly on the ground and melted into the Rose Gardens. The missile was coming in with terrible speed and power, too much coming at Yoda too fast ever to wholly stop it. Even he had time and perfect peace, but he reached out to pull up the Force, binding even Bajun's bitter green moss and twisted thorn trees, and let it flow through him like a wind, the breath of a world, gathering to release it in a push-feather game with all their lives on the line not to oppose the missile's force with force, but to touch it gently on one side just enough to send it screaming by the broken window, casting to plunge a kilometer offshore into the cold and waiting sea. A long instant later, water fountain from the ocean in a blaze of light, 300 meters tall, and then fell back. The chateau and all those inside had been spared, but Dooku was gone. Also in Yoda Dark Rendezvous, I'm only going to mention that about another 50 times, Yoda was able to easily hold up a starfighter with telekinesis, and was able to lift Luke Skywalker's X-Wing out of the Dagobah swamp with ease, impressing Luke as even with immense strain, concentration, and peace, Luke was unable to do it as an Empire Strikes Back, showing Yoda's superiority over Luke. Similarly, Yoda was immensely powerful, with Mace Windu believing that Yoda is capable of lifting a steam crawler with the Force, something that Mace Windu himself admitted that he was not capable of doing, with both Master Yoda and Mace Windu utilizing a complex Force wave ability to blow away dozens, if not hundreds, of battle droids during the Battle of Coruscant simultaneously, with their combined power, being venerated to be the most powerful members of the Jedi Order until the rise of Anakin Skywalker. In the Shatterpoint novel, Mace notes the following about Yoda's power. Mace opened himself up to the Force. He could hear Yoda's voice, size matters not. which Mace had already privately considered, was more true than Yoda than it was for any of his students. Yoda would probably just reach out, release the steam crawler from the gully, and casually float it up onto the mountain of the outpost while croaking some enigmatic maxim about how even a volcano is as nothing compared to the power of the Force. Mace was much less confident in his own raw power. Master Yoda was also able to utilize telekinesis to incur an avalanche that was able to wipe out several chameleon droids, creating an enormous avalanche and pile of snow with telekinesis, causing part of a mountain to crash down. Perhaps one of his most impressive telekinetic feats, he was able to use telekinesis to levitate various pieces of the Island Jedi Temple, which was currently in ruins. And Master Yoda was also telekinetically able to lift and maneuver dozens of destroyer droids and hold them consistently in the path of Separatist starfighters, taking out both of the targets at once. He was also able to, and this in my opinion being his most impressive telekinetic feat, with brief concentration and focus, as well as strain, he was able to telekinetically force droid transports right back into their landing craft and then push it back, while telekinetically pushing a Separatist landing craft. Yoda utilized the Force to grab another one and slam it into the former craft, destroying both of them and all the battle droids inside with only a brief lapse of concentration. Yoda was also able to use telekinesis to hold a sized Ventress back from striking down the Toydarian King Tunko, and was able to employ Force push against Ventress to shoot her back easily. She was similarly able to casually disarm Ventress of her lightsabers using the Force, bringing them into his hand, and was able to throw back Plo Koon, Sayasay Tin, and Depa Balaba simultaneously with telekinesis, with Plo Koon vastly outclassing Kit Fisto, Sayasay Tin being a rival to Fisto, and Depa Balaba being venerated by Mace Windu as perhaps having the potential to be more powerful than him. While the feat is commonly believed to be a feat of speed, it is made apparent in the source that the lesson was based on telekinesis primarily, as in Darth Maul's Shadowhunter. This quote goes as follows. Yoda had faced the assembled students and spoken, his thin, reedy voice somehow carrying to the far corners of the lecture hall without the benefit of amplifiers. Better than training, the Force is, more than experience or speed it gives. And he had given a demonstration. Three members of the council, Plo Koon, Sayasay Tin, and Depa Balaba, excellent fighters, all had come forward and attacked him. Master Yoda had not been armed, and had not seemed to move more than a meter or so, his tread slow and measured. Nevertheless, none of the three had been able to lay a finger on him. The lesson had struck powerfully home. Knowledge of the Force was infinitely better than technique. In perhaps his most impressive combative display of telekinesis, Yoda was able to hoist back Darth Sidious with a powerful Force push with ease, catching Sidious off guard, who had reaction speed capable of keeping up with Mace Windu, who Anakin perceived as being so fast he could barely perceive his movements, believing that Mace no longer existed as an independent being and rather a swirling being of light. Similarly to many mental abilities that we mentioned previously, like the mind trick, Yoda was able to exert his ability over telepathy, being able to receive Obi-Wan's thoughts from a great distance, and Master Yoda was also able to read Dooku's thoughts. Dooku saw that he had been tricked. He had no doubt that he and Lorian had made team captains deliberately. The Jedi Council had wanted to pit them against each other to see how deep the tensions ran. Tricked you or not, Yoda said, as if he'd read Dooku's thoughts. Given an opportunity, you were. Not alone are you, Dooku. To ask for help is no shame. With his willpower, however, this is where Yoda truly shines. However, not as having as much willpower as the likes of Revan or Vishyr, who possess perhaps more willpower than anyone in Star Wars, Master Yoda was able to successfully go up against and conquer his dark soul, as well as his hubris in a trial by the cosmic beings known as the Force Priestesses. Although this was in canon, I still believe that it is notable in the EU. Master Yoda was also able to perceive through the illusion of Darth Bane generated on the homeworld of Korriban. Jedi Master Yoda was able to encounter the giant specter of Bane while visiting the Sith homeworld of Korriban. And once a Jedi dismissed the spirit to be nothing more than illusion, it dissipated dead back into his tomb. Master Yoda was also able to perceive an illusion of a tranquil Jedi temple, where Dooku had never left the Order prior to the outbreak of the Clone Wars. In a vision, where Sidious and Dooku attempted to break Yoda's willpower, he was able to conquer the Dark Lord, overcoming the Sith sorcery that Darth Sidious and Count Dooku combined implemented in an attempt to break him, further assuring Yoda's superiority over at least the Clone Wars Season 6 Darth Sidious. With his last Force ability we will be reviewing today, we have the ability of Force Ghost, the rare ability that was nigh unheard of in the Old Republic era and in the New era. to transcend the physical plane and become a force spirit, an example of the Jedi's ability to retain their identity after death and shift from the physical plane into the cosmic force. Through this means, the Jedi can appear to others to offer counsel and wisdom to those who require. Master Yoda was able to transcend the physical realm and become a force spirit, appearing to Luke Skywalker following the deaths of Darth Vader and Emperor Palpatine, and continued to appear for some time to offer advice and wisdom to Luke until the Jedi had no longer needed him. With the quote from the Star Wars Fact Files going as follows. The Jedi Master was not gone forever. Yoda reappeared to Luke Skywalker in spirit form alongside the spirits of Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi following the Battle of Endor. And in the years following Yoda's death, he appeared again on a handful of occasions to offer the young Jedi help and advice as he sought out others for training. As Skywalker's knowledge of the Force grew, Yoda's influence diminished until he was no longer needed. So my friends, what did you think of this lore video? Yoda is one of my favourite characters in all of the lore, and in my personal opinion, he's one of the most interesting, intriguing, as well as one of the most mysterious characters in the entirety of the Star Wars universe, as well as one of its most powerful. I desired to make this video about Yoda's power, as in my opinion, he is among the most powerful Jedi of all time. Third, in my opinion, behind only the Chosen One Anakin Skywalker, and his son in Luke Skywalker. So my friends, I'll see you in a galaxy far, far away. Be sure to slap that subscribe button and hit like and recommend this to a friend who you believe would be interested in learning more about the lore on this channel. And if you want to see other power breakdowns, or even just long lore videos, recommend them in the comments below and I will be sure to give them a go. So my friends, this is where we part ways, and I'll see you in a galaxy far, far away.